morning to all. Theorem number 1.9, first part, second part. If A is a non-singular matrix of order n, then first part, anti-A the whole inverse equal to anti-A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A into I. Okay. So, first part namaba. So, first part, what is given? Given A is non-singular. Given A is non-singular. Therefore, determinant of A not equal to 0. Therefore, A inverse exists. A inverse exists. So, we know the formula. We know that A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. This implies cross multiplying determinant of A into A inverse equal to adjoint of A. This is equation number 1. So taking inverse on both sides of equation number 1, taking inverse on both sides, both sides. Okay, so taking inverse on both sides means first RHS will be RHS HA the whole inverse equal to determinant of A into A inverse the whole inverse. Now the formula AB the whole inverse equal to B inverse into A inverse. That formula we know. So here it is equal to A inverse the whole inverse into determinant of A inverse. Okay, now by theorem 1.8, A inverse the whole inverse equal to A. By theorem 1.4, determinant of A the whole inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A. Okay, this is our theorem 1.4, 1.8. Now we have to learn. So, A inverse the whole inverse A substitute. Here it is A. Determinant of A the whole inverse 1 by determinant of A. So A into 1 by determinant of A. Okay, two theorem. Therefore, anti A the whole inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A into A, equation number 2. Now anti A in the second part in the first part, second. So replacing A by A inverse. A by A inverse in equation number 1. First equation A to A inverse proper. So first equation A inverse what? Determinant of A inverse. A inverse the whole inverse equal to adjoint of A inverse. Now, what is the theorem? Anti A inverse equal to A inverse, determinant of A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A into A inverse the whole inverse is equal to A. Equation number 2. So, this is equation number 3. So from 2 and 3, what is that? Anti A the whole inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A into A. Anti A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A into A. RHS are equal. Therefore, anti A the whole inverse equal to anti A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A into A. This is 1.9. First part over. Now, second part over. Second part, what is determinant of anti A is equal to? So, shall I repeat? Okay, next. For the second part, already we know that one condition. What is the for the second one? We know that A into adjoint of A equal to anti A into A equal to determinant of A into I. Okay, then, idhila first paathi last paathi nam choose pannuvom. So take A into adjoint of A equal to determinant of A into take In, because the given matrices of order N, therefore you take In. Okay, now taking determinant on both sides, taking determinant on both sides. Okay, then what is that? Determinant of A into adj of A, determinant of A into adj of A into adj of A, determinant of A into I n. Okay, now determinant of A B n am pirikiram ena determinant of A B equal to determinant of A into determinant of B. Still one only. So ingeyum determinant of A into determinant of adj A equal to determinant kulla or determinant varumbodhu and the determinant oda power order of the matrix. So order of the matrix what? N. Adanaga inga nama enna panna porom determinant of A the whole power N. Determinant kulla or determinant varumbodhu and the determinant oda power the order. Okay, now adjoint of A namakku theva, determinant of adj A namakku theva. So determinant of A kondu poiruvom. So determinant of A the whole power N by determinant of A, which is equal to determinant of A the whole power N, denominator numerator varumbodhu determinant of A the whole power minus 1. Therefore finally adjoint of determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A the whole power N minus 1. Okay, here number 1.9, first part and second part. Okay friends, study well. Okay, subscribe Mercury Maths, go send out.